Hello and welcome to the episode 85 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Some of the highlights of this episode include more filming on the Beatles' feature movies, a return from India, and a couple of mixing sessions. On the 26th of March 1961, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed their last Liverpool gig before leaving for their second ever residency in Hamburg, West Germany. Fittingly, it was a quiet, so to speak, Sunday night engagement at Mona Best's Casbah Coffee Club. 1 year later, in 1962, the Beatles, still with Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. In 1963, the Beatles returned at the Granada Cinema in Mansfield, about a month after their last performance at the venue. On the 23rd of February, it had been for the Helen Shapiro Package Tour, whereas, on this day, it was with Chris Montez and Tommy Rowe for their second national package tour. In 1964, the Beatles were at the Scala Theatre in London for their fourth and last day of filming of the TV performance bit for their A Hard Day's Night movie. By the way, if you're liking this podcast so far, you might want to head to www.simonmas.com/support to see how you can help me to make it even better. In fact, you can be instrumental to help me to put out, for free, even more music-related series. No donation is too small, but you'll see that you don't need to part with your money to be fab and make the difference. Thank you. More filming 1 year later on the 26th of March 1965. On this day, the Beatles completed the shooting for their interior temple sequences at the Twickenham Film Studios in London for their forthcoming new flicks, Eight Arms to Hold You, or Help, as we all know it. Also on this date, NEMS announced that the original soundtrack of the film would have included the Beatles' new songs and additional instrumental music. The plan was abandoned in UK after the Beatles recorded more new songs during May and June 1965. In 1968, it was Paul McCartney, Jane Asher, and Neil Aspinall's turn to leave Rishikesh, India, after Ringo Starr and his wife Maureen had left on the 1st of March, as detailed in episode 60 of What a Fab Day. To the press, Paul had nothing but good words about the period and meditation, but he felt it was time to return to England and back to his own life. In the anthology book, Paul recalls, "Being fairly practical, I had set a period for staying in Rishikesh. If it had turned out to be something we really had to go back for, I would have gone back. But at the end of my month, I was quite happy to leave. Nobody got any blinding enlightenment. I thought, this will do for me. If I want to get into it heavily, I can do it anywhere. That's one of the nice things about meditation. You don't have to go to church to do it." Moving on to 1969, four mono mixes of Get Back were prepared today at the EMI Studios by George Martin and engineer Jeff Jarrett in preparation for the release of the song as a single. Acetates of the mixes were delivered to the Beatles to hear their opinion on which one would be the best. None of them pleased the band, and so today's work was left unreleased. More mixing in 1970 with Phil Spector continuing his work on the Get Back tapes at the EMI Studios. Today, he mixed Let It Be, adding such a prominent echo on Ringo's hi-hat that it will later become a point of contention, and substituting the 4th of January guitar solo to the one used in the issued single. He also artificially extended the duration of the song with an edit, creating the impression of working on another take compared to the single. The same impression was created with Get Back, thanks to the addition of some chatter at the start of the take, and of the applause and the thanks following the last song of the Upper Rooftop concert. The session was concluded with the remix of Maggie May and The Long and Winding Road. This latter song, at this stage, featured a much simpler mix than the one eventually issued, without any orchestral score superimposed to the existing track. But it was probably a quick reference mix to pass on to the arranger and the musicians that would be called in to record said orchestral bed. This concludes this episode of What a Fab Day. We'll have much more mixing tomorrow. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.